the distinguished dignitaries, Professor Prakash Babu, Vice Chancellor, Dean School of Medical Sciences, University of Hyderabad, to take the seat on the dais. May I now request Dr. H.S. Bawaskar, Physician, Malad, Maharashtra, to take the seat on the dais. May I now request Professor Geeta K. Vemuganti, Professor, School of Medical Sciences, University of Hyderabad, to take the seat on the dais. May I now request the dignitaries to light the lamp and garland the portrait of Dr. Yellapragada Subbarao. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, sir. May I now request Professor Prakash Babu, Pro Vice Chancellor and Dean School of Medical Sciences, University of Hyderabad, to deliver the welcome address.
Very good afternoon, all of you. The today's guest, Dr. Bawaskar, my colleague, Professor Geeta Vemuganti, and other colleagues sitting in the audience and dear students. It's a great honor again to organize Dr. Yellapragada Subbarao's lecture. Every year, the earlier School of Life Sciences used to organize, followed by now the medical sciences taking care of the lecture every year by inviting the eminent personalities in the scientific field of particular area, and to honor the Dr. Subbarao, and as well as the having the special guests with the University of Hyderabad. And this is the occasion to remember Dr. Subbarao. Anyway, Professor Geeta must be explaining about the reading his biography. But only one thing I would like to point out on this occasion, that if you see the Dr. Subbarao's life and profile, his education, his scientific temper, and his discoveries, they're all in odd circumstances. He studied in a very rare circumstance in the poverty, and he used to go to school around 20 kilometers away from the by walk, and he doesn't have money to complete, and he has to write examinations several times, but finally somebody has to help him to study and go abroad. There also it's not very smooth, but with all these circumstances, now Dr. Subbarao is just remembered throughout the world as synonym for several drugs, several of his discoveries. And another important point is, Dr. Subbarao discoveries, when you see, basically some of them, if you take the Heterzan drug discovered by Dr. Subbarao, which is a filariasis, against the filarial worms, this is the disease that is prevalent in his native place. And Dr. Subbarao, incidentally, from one of the Telugu states, from near Rajahmundry, as name also denotes, and that area is known for this filariasis, and therefore he wanted to do something for the place, and he discovered such a way, folic acid, several things. So what I would like to say is, the scientific temper should include the your environment. What is your immediate cause, immediate responsibility, immediately how your personal are suffering, and you should be in a position to alleviate the people from that suffering. So that is another important aspect to be learned by the students. With these few words, sir, this university, I think this is first time that you are visiting the University of Hyderabad. It's a beautiful campus, as you have seen. So we used to have around 2,600 acres. Now we have around 2,000 acres. But good land is, plain land is 1,600 acres. We have 12 schools and one integrated studies program. And basically, this university is known for the research. And students are very studious because faculty members are studious. And they attend very regularly classes because faculty members, we don't skip any class. In fact, if there is any strike, bund or rain or anything, still classes will keep going. We announce the examination schedule, classes schedule, everything and results in the beginning of the academic year, and we will follow the same thing until that academic year. and we have around 600 students, 6,000 students are in the campus. Mostly these students are 90% of the students, they stay back in the campus itself. It's a completely residential, almost residential campus. And we have a health center also. So our one of the medical officers, retired medical officers, is also here. She is also here. And with this small background, and as indicated to you, Dr. Subbarao's contribution, despite hardships and social relevance, immediately. And today's speaker is same. So that's why when he talk about his lectures, you can also understand how he is struggled to get into the as a doctor and the researcher. And he has several good publications, whether he has studied his biography given in the announcement. And he has several Lancet publications. That's what I keep discussing. So one Lancet publication for one lifetime is enough, sir. That's what I'm telling. So from the remote place in Maharashtra, serving the people. And when Dr. Geeta Vimuganti did, in conversation during lunchtime, he said that many people are poor background, they have come to us, so I cannot forego them. So this is the kind of tendency we have. We see very few doctors are there with such a kind of tendency towards the patients of the socioeconomically backward. And maybe after listening to his lecture, you will appreciate that one. He's a good doctor, a researcher, and a social reformer. So with these few words, sir, I welcome you to the University of Hyderabad, and we are eager to listen to your lectures. I thank Professor Geeta for all these arrangements. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. May I now request Professor Geeta K. Vemuganti, School of Medical Sciences, to introduce our speaker to the gathering.
Good afternoon, everyone. It's indeed an honor. I must share this, that we all read about Dr. Bawaskar in our medical books and in practice, but I never met him. And last year when we were sharing a dais in Karimnagar, I was pleasantly surprised. I didn't even know how to react when I met him in person, because he is a man who has the maximum number of Lancet publications. At the age of 30, he had his first Lancet publication and 20 plus Lancet letters. And I don't think we are ever going to meet a person who would have treated more than 2,000 cases of scorpion bites and snake bites. He's living legend, I would say. A very simple person, humble. And we all talk about not having research tools, but his research tool has been a stethoscope and a record keeping. So I would just go back to the reason why we are all here. This is to pay respects to Dr. Yellapragada Subba Rao, who is one of the most well-known clinician scientists. And suddenly the government of India realized that we haven't done enough to honor him. And since many years, this lecture has been conducted at School of Life Sciences. And since the school came into picture, we started conducting these. He was born in Bhimavaram in 1985. So we intend to keep his lecture in August because his death anniversary falls on 9th August. And he died in New York, USA. Unfortunately, it's a custom that we should invite the family members, but we do not have any records or any contacts with his family members, though one of our own staff has a Yellapragada surname. But I asked him, but our IA is not related. So Dr. Subba Rao, he was born into a Telugu family in Bhimavaram. And as Professor Prakash Babu emphasized, he had a very traumatic period in his schooling. And he faced many deaths like many people at that age. And he's matriculated. This is especially for the students. One failure is not a big deal. He's one person, and especially in medicine, I would remember all the senior people saying, I passed in second attempt, third attempt, fourth attempt. So it's not a life and death situation. He also cleared his matriculation in the third attempt. And he did his intermediate examination from the presidency college. And then he went to Madras Medical College, and he was supported by his friends and his mentor and friend Dr. Kasturi Suryanarayana's Murthy's daughter. He subsequently married. He had many ups and downs in his life, And this is especially following Mahatma Gandhi's boycott movement. Everyone, he started wearing the khadi surgical dress. And this was taken as, you know, it didn't go well with his surgery professor. And he believes that, I mean, all the papers mention that though he did very well, he didn't clear. So there was something called as a lesser degree for medicine. And that was the LMS certificate that he got. Then he tried to enter into Madras Medical Service without success. Subsequently, he got an anatomy professor's lecturer's job in an Ayurvedic medical college. And then he began his research in Ayurveda. It was just by pure chance, like many of us go through, that he, when he was visiting, the American doctor who was visiting the Rockefeller scholarship, the promise of support came from Malladi Satyalingam, and the financial assistance to him was given by his father-in-law, and then he went to US to subsequently. He was in Boston. He had his diploma from Harvard Medical School. And that's when last year I remember when I was mentioning this, the biochemistry professor said, how important is the estimation of phosphorus in body fluids and tissues. He developed this technique with Cyrus Fiske. And he also discovered the role of phosphocreatine. He joined a lab, which is Lederle Lab, and it is now a division of American Cyanide. And he was denied a regular faculty position at that time. And subsequently, he went on to synthesize folic acid. If all of us are healthy and living today, it's because our mothers had adequate folic acid levels to give birth to normal children. Because that's as important as having normal levels, because otherwise it's a very, very problematic if you don't have adequate level of folic acid. And not just at antenatal, it should be prenatal, as one of the speakers had highlighted earlier. And his contribution is methotrexate. Again, it's a drug, miracle drug, not only for cancer biology, but also for many of the autoimmune diseases now they are using with the liver profile updates. And Heterzan, as Professor Prakash Babu mentioned. And he had many other, tetracycline. And one of the fungus was named after him. And many people think that he has he was denied the recognition and achievements. No interviews, no claims. But of course, there is a Wikipedia. You can go through that. And his colleague, George Hitchinings, who shared the Nobel Prize in Physiology. Many people believe, like when you Nobel Prize, there is one book where all the Nobel stories are there, 100 Nobel. The details of the discovery is released later on, not when in for first 30 years. Later on, it was discovered that his contribution was equally high, and because of jealousy factor, his contribution was not recognized. So as the best way of his contribution, which is summarized is you would have probably never heard of Dr. Yellapragada Subba Rao, because he lived so that you may be alive today, like I just mentioned, all of us are there. And because he lived so that we may live longer. So with this, this is his biography. And since School of Medical Sciences started this, conducting this, I would just like to summarize those who recall. The continuation of the series, we had Professor Dr. Girish Sahani, who was one of the persons who prepared the drug which lyses the clot and saves all the lives in the golden hour. And he gave the first lecture in 2014 in our school, followed by Dr. Shashikaran, that is folic acid. He talked about, he was ex-director of NIN. Then we had Dr. Chandak, who is a clinician scientist again, who talked about obesity and diabetes, and especially in the Indian scenario. And last year, we had a very, very unusual, a very senior professor, who emphasized on all the discoveries made outside the medical field, but applied to the medical field. So that shows the teamwork and the usefulness of the so-called useless knowledge, which many people report, and in the advances of modern science. And Dr. Krishnaswamy had last year presented this. And now we are very, very fortunate that we have Dr. Bawaskar with us, and who has As I said, in fact, by lunch, he mentioned a joke that when he went to one of the medical colleges, when his name came out, then one of the students very naively said, "Oh, I didn't know, sir, you were alive." So because his name is so legendary, when I sent the mail to some of the colleagues here, he said, "Oh, he's our hero," because those in emergency practice know his name by his work. And I thought I will read about his biography, but because he has a lot of work, a lot of slides to teach us. So few things: a simple, humble person whose research tool was a stethoscope and his record keeping. Who went through all the hardships. And in fact, one of the very touching stories is he was working with a child whom they had given up, and everyone thought the child is dead. And he was treating that child, and he wanted to sit with the child throughout the night. And he comes to know that his father died. And he decided not to go to the funeral. He said, "Others can attend to the funeral. Nobody can attend to the boy." So that speaks of his values, and that speaks of his conviction in his journey against this. And as I said, I will never in my lifetime meet a person or talk to a person who has contributed so much in this snake bite. So I would, as I said, I don't want to read. And he still is walking 10 kilometers a day. And he gives free service. And about his work, you'll be surprised to see how much work he has done. And I will let you learn from him directly. With that, Professor Bawaskar, thank you very much. We are honored that you are here today. And you took the whole day off. And the whole day has been driving to be here. He traveled 300 kilometers from Malad to Mumbai, Mumbai to Hyderabad. And he will get back again, back to his place to take care of his patients. Sir, thank you very much for being here. And I thank Professor Prakash Babu for facilitating this lecture. And thank all of you for being here. And may I request, sir, to please start your lecture. Thank you so much.
Thank you, madam. Thank you, sir. See, what the Subba Rao has not honored or not given this award of Nobel. Say my experience, my paper, which has rejected from Indian Journal, was published in The Lancet. Now, the problem is that what Subba Rao was thought in the Heterzan treatment, because his colleague was suffering, his relative was suffering. Similarly, when I joined the primary health center, children used to die of massive pulmonary edema of scar patient. Literature was not aware. Propace was not aware. I have myself to search out, and ultimately mortality reduced to less than 1%. It was 40%. Now, let us start with the snake bite. See, these are the four common, big four, what are say the common snake which found all over India. First is the crate. Crate is the most venomous. It is a 10 times poison than cobra. And most important, crate bite is unknown to the patients. No local sign at all. Patients sleep on the floor bed, woke up with a pain in abdomen, come with descending neuroparalysis. Unless doctor is aware, he can diagnose the patient may die of neurological maladies like stroke, just like GP syndrome or hysteria. Next is a cobra. Cobra, everybody knows cobra is very cardiac toxicity and respiratory paralysis. Next is Russell viper. Commonest farmers died of Russell viper due to renal failure. Majority of farmers die because of renal failure because the Russell viper not treated in time. Last is Ichthys carinatus, which is less venomous, but it does cause renal failure in Pondicherry and Jammu. So this is very important big four found all over the India. Now this is my lecture. Everybody know how to start for the snake and unum. This will go step by step. Now this is very important. It's a snake invasion, it's a major public health problem. More than 75% victim not go to the government health services. Why? Because doctor may not be available during night hours. And they don't believe, they believe in myth. Going to the mantra, because 90% snakes are non-venomous. And that is the reason why the patient not attending to the primary health center. Next important, they don't go to private because the expensive treatment. Next, now this is a problem of poor farmers. India has highest snake bite mortality. 50% patient dies each year due to snake bite. Innovations also argued that this poverty affecting mainly the farmers, labor, hunters, weather, and most important, why illiteracy of doctors? So very important, the illiteracy of doctors. Farmers, he has no pocket and no money at all. And he came with a life-threatening emergency. And most when he go to the hospital, he feel that he will be cured. But illiteracy of doctor. Doctor is not aware of the management, diagnosis of snake bite. Victims are diagnosed and dose of ASU in ventilators. They are not knowing how much dose of ASU to be given. Most important, what Mahatma Gandhi says, villagers are the backbone of India. Sincerity, dedication and devotion, which is very important to be retained in the medical profession. But dedication, devotion is lost because of Consumer Protection Act. Sincerity is only retained now. And many doctors, because of laws, don't want to treat the emergencies. Now this is very important. See how in the patient with the Russell Viper may come with a profuse bleeding, great weight come neuroparalysis, and this is because of life-threatening and time-limiting phenomena, and patient is aware that he wants cure only. Patient interested in the cure, not the smell of the what. Because you see, sunflower never smell. Rose is beautiful, but sunflower yield. That's a very important. Our research may not be sophisticated, but it should give benefit to the society. Now this what, in the early in the morning, a doctor is busy in the morning, he receives the ward boy, come with the call that patient come with some unknown symptoms. Patient cannot talk, he is unconscious, he cannot open the eyes, doctor is not aware. But he has gone to see the patient, he feel patient is there. You see, my bilateral ptosis, pulling of saliva, this is a bilateral ptosis. If he has never seen the patient, he cannot diagnose, because patient do not give the history of snake bite. This is a crate bite victim. During night, crate enter, because it's a nocturnal crate enter in the house. Bite to the person who sleep on the floor bed. Their fangs are very sharp, short and sharp. Patient is unaware of the bite at all. Patient woke up with the pain in abdomen, then vomiting and descending paralysis. So if the doctor is aware of this sign, if the history of pain in abdomen, descending paralysis, he diagnose crate bite and treat, patient will recover. Next important, it's a very important thing. How the patient... You see, this is the problem. This 12 years old boy was left home. He was stayed home and our parents had gone for labor work. And this child was unable to wake up. So ultimately, when they come afternoon, child was unconscious, was brought to the hospital, and patient has a crate bite. This is the problem of poverty. Now this child was brought dead. Midnight child was gone to the hospital with a suffocation because of respiratory paralysis. Doctor diagnosed bronchopneumonia, given him some treatment and sent home. Child was brought dead to my hospital. So this was a crate bite. Now how, see, this is the ambulance of 18th century British. Still the patients are carried like this in my area by the bamboo basket because of poor transport facility during night. And this is the reason why the patient is late to the hospital. Patient become severe because doctor late to examine. Next patient become dead because doctor is illiterate. Next, this is what, now the addressing the snake bite is a neglected tropical disease. Many included tropical disease, a neglected disease of India. Even it is all over the world, and WHO has recognized the most neglected disease in the world, and now the WHO has accepted there is some research and some important development of snake bite should be going on in the world. Now, most important, many doctors think there is no anti-venom available at primary center. It is not a duty of a government. It is a duty of a doctor to procure the anti-venom. No government is poor anywhere in the world. Even India government is not poor. They supply enough anti-venom. But doctor is not procuring anti-venom because they are afraid to give the anti-venom because they are afraid of anaphylaxis reactions. Next important, this is a responsibility of medical officer, not the government, to have anti-venom. Next important, it is no stone should be left unturned to treat and save the honest and sincere slaves of motherland, that is farmers. Now this is very important. What do we see? The poverty. Because this is a disease of poverty which I probably Lancet. Because of excessive poverty which occur, again because of going to the private hospital, the victim become heavy in debt and subsequently they commit suicide rather than died of snake bite. Now this why in a Bombay even hospital, fatal underlying Bombay even 6 years old boy, more hospitals, hospital cobra don't get antivenom and died of respiratory failure. So it is very important even urban or cosmopolitan city doctors should know how the manifestation of cobra crate bite can occur. This is a very important death. Commissioner Rennie says were common seen in the this is the event where we'll get many snake bite cases. Now you see, only doctors should not know, because you see nurses are more trained. They're regularly with the patients. So this is one of the patients was admitted at midnight with the pain in abdomen. The surgeon diagnosed appendicitis and admitted to the ward. No sooner the patient gone to the ward, nurse diagnosed grade 8 and patient died. So ultimately, irrespective of qualification, it is experience stand first. Now this very, again, this is 4 children died of grade 8. Even this tribal residential schools, maximum children, because they sleep on the floor, maximum children are killed by this crate victims, crate bite. Now this little knowledge is very important. Little knowledge, medical negligence is a crime. You see, this is a young farmers which was just taking care of the cattle, was beaten by the cobra, gone to the primary health center, telling the doctor, I am beaten by the cobra. He develops a slurred speech and ptosis and descending paralysis. The doctor afraid to give antivenom, brought to the Mahal, he was dead. So this is a time-limiting, life-threatening phenomena which should be treated in time. Now this why important medical profession? You see, accuracy of science. You see, clinical medicine is always on the top, irrespective of whatever the modern investigation, modern information technology goes ahead. Ultimately, it's a sign and symptom. If you don't take the history in the crate bite, patient may be misdiagnosed. And you should change the sign according to your clinical observation, and you can change the revise the diagnosis. Because we must have collected good data to prepare the paper or to publish, because we cannot make a brick without play, what William Osler said long back. Now this very, what are the risk factors? Waiting, this is a tribal fellow beaten by the Russell Viper, see edema developed bleeding, he is waiting for the doctors. Waiting of doctors adding one of the risk adding extra risk to the patient development of serious manifesting, so he should not wait, because we doctors are more afraid of chest pain, more afraid of politician to come to the OPD rather than the poor man. So this is actual medical emergency treated in the time. Now this is very important. Now this, why I'm putting this slide, you see the snake bite fellow, child was brought 17 miles in 7 minutes. So rapidly child was brought to the primary health center. If doctor do not aggressively treat the patient, will die. That's why if you don't treat the patient, the hour your ambassador is sleeping with the Pakistan. So don't sleep with the enemies. It's a very, very important. You must treat the patient in time. Now many times the patient did not bring the snake, but they can see the snake, what has beaten up snake out. Now they can bring the photographs in the mobile phones. But you can prepare a card like this, photographs. This is Russell Viper, Cobra, Crate, and Equus Carinator. So can easily they label, this was a snake beaten to him. So we can go ahead for the treatment. Now again, the mobile, they can bring the photographs in mobile and you can treat accordingly. Now this is a risk factor, loose stones, firewoods, barefoot walking in soybean plantation, barefoot walking to the going to the school, even unusual bag can have held the cobra and creep. Next important, this harvesting the grass, left hand is goes blind in the grass, get left hand bitten by the Equus carinator. That soybean pesticide, the father is committed suicide and he is barefoot walking, they are serving in the farm. And this sometimes creative in early darkness moves on the road, may get a snake bite. This is very important. These are called the risk factors which involve in the snake bite. Even pakka house, if you get a twigs around the house, now these twigs can carry it through the windows, the snakes. So the pakka house is not free from snake bite. Even your AC window or AC cupboard can take out the crickets carinator while fitting to the house. Now this is very important. This, if the your rest house, very beautiful 5-star rest house having such type of grown grass or grown plantation, not free from snake bite. Now very important, farmers, see. Many times this switch is put over the iron rod or iron pillars, but farmers are not aware. They put on the limb tree stem and you get a cobra bite here. While opening the switch, patient get a cobra bite. So this is a mischief of the MSCP, not of farmers. Farmer is not aware of it. Now the most important is the slit between the door and beneath that is through which the cobra and crate can enter in the house and patient get a crate bite. This is the crate brought by this patient who developed a crate bite sign. Now many times we get a crate bite. This is a critical care chair, wheelchair, and critical care clinical care units in cardiology. Even you get a reception table, the wrestler, this is a pit wiper. Even the TV set, we get a crate white. Even this cold storage, cold drinker storage, you will get a wrestle wipers. So these are various stage, we can get various snakes. Now, this is very important. What to say, in the 1998 to 2004, we are not aware of more snake bite clinical manifestation. Mortality was 33% crate bite. When we are becoming understanding the use of ASV, dose of ASV and ventilator, mortality dropped to 10%. Same is cobra bite, 25% to gravy 8%. So ultimately, mortality down because of simply understanding the pathophysiology of envenoming. Now, commonest maximum cases are seen during, this is monsoon season, June to November. This is a particular season, we get maximum cases of snake bite. Now, this is very important to know the color of the snake. Now, if the dark color, you see, snake is a cold-blooded animal. If the skin is dark, it is a poor conductor of the heat. The body temperature of snake will be rise. So, the venom will be in a liquid form, and venom will be injected very speedily, more quantity. If it's a light color, less blood venom, so venom will be viscous, and less venom will be injected. So, dark color is more venomous than the light color. Now, what are the various toxicity we get in neurotoxin, cytotoxicity, which can cobra bite, can local cytotoxicity, because lysolecithin and three finger antitoxin, which is called the cell damage locally by lysolecithin, that is used, can be used to treat the cancer cell now, which is research is going on to find the anti-cancer drugs in cobra venom. Neurotoxicity, we see the pre-synaptic, post-synaptic blocker, hematoxicity, bleeding disorder, cardiac toxicity, cardiac arrest, and myotoxicity, which comes in the sea snake because we get severe myositic pain and hyperkalemia, and renal toxicity, which are discussed, we are talking just about Russell Viper. Now let us see the crate. I will emphasize crate is most important. It is a nocturnal. Its fangs is short and sharp, just like insulin needle. Its venom is 10 times poisonous than cobra. It's with bite to the present sleep on the floor bed. Because during night, it is entering the house in the search of the rats. No local manifestation at all. Patient is not aware of the bite at all. Patient may feel ant bite, rat bite, and no bite at all. And patient, because soon it bite, during night, there is reflexes are blunted. During sleep, circulation of skin is poor. And during sleep, because of the venom is injected, it slowly absorbed, so to manifestation delayed. No sooner the venom is absorbed, it will release the acetylcholine in the body, presynaptic receptor. And acid liberation causes pain in abdomen, vomiting and sweating. And because of vomiting, the relative or patient feel indigestion, goes to sleep again. After 2 to 3 hours, he woke up with a blurring of vision. We have a blurring of vision, descending paralysis, unable to lift the neck, unable to move the limbs. Patient start paralysis, and this may be diagnosed appendicitis, acute abdomen, head injury, and hysteria. And may be admitted with a chest pain, intensive care unit. So locked-in syndrome, these are the various difficult manifestations which make the crate bite to diagnose. And this is very important to emphasize. Many of my patients in early stage died, misdiagnosed crate bite with various diseases and died at home. So this is why, this child was brought to the general physician, was pain in abdomen, diagnosed acute abdomen. He referred to the surgeon. Surgeon diagnosed acute appendicitis and advised for the sonography. Patient was unable to stand up. Patient was referred to me. He had a snake bite here. And so his relative brought the crate. So ultimately the crate bite. And again, this is very important. See, pulling of saliva. Unable, this pulling of saliva, patient is unable to swallow the saliva, spitting saliva, indication patient need ventilator. Anywhere bite can occur over abdomen, patient is not aware at all. And if a recovery which can fast if you treat in time, and this is the place where patient was brought from. He was just like this university area. This is like university where can get a crate. Next, this is again a crate bite. See, though no bite site, see. Minimum bites are marked. When you see the bite site, you'll have to extend the search of the lower body and you get urticaria around the bite. This is confirmed in venom. So this is very fangs, sharp fangs of the crate. Now the very important thing is this is a bite site over the back. See? Patient went, he's got a bite site over the back. Now patient has a bite by the nose, nostril, swelling of the nostril. And patient was recovered completely with the crate bite. Now this is very important, bite over the hand, multiple bites. Patient get a 23 meter deep profound paralysis. Patient is totally unconscious. Page reflexes are absent, but plantars are extensor, and then with a 2 to 3 hours patient get a deep paralysis. First is profound, then deep paralysis, and then we get patient get a recovery treated in time. So this is very, very important. Just recover with the antivenom, neostigmine, atropine, ventilator, we give life to the patient. No need ultra-monitor invasive like CT scan, MRI, lumbar spine, whatever initiation. Nothing needed. Only clinical medicine updated will diagnose this victim and patient can be saved. He is a god. When you look at the patient, recover from the crate bite, you feel it is god, not to go to Tirupati Balaji at all. Now, this again, this patient was brought in unconscious state in the morning. Nobody was knowing what happened. I was called to see the comatose patient. But when I said close the eye, he was closing. So, patient is conscious. That's a quadriplegia, no movement at all. Patient is not comatose at all. Patient is conscious. That's a glaucoma scale is applicable, not applicable, sensation. And very important, this patient's pupils are dilated, not reacting to pupils, not even light. Again, the doctors think it is a brain dead. It is wrong. Because pupils are, the iris is rich in vascular supply, rich in smooth muscle, rich in acetylcholine receptor, and this venom rich in, it goes to the where circulation more, so it's rich in quantity in the iris, and more reflex, more paralysis of receptacle, so we get a dilatation of the pupils, is not a sign of brain death. So many times, doctor diagnose brain death, referred back to the home, or patient is not recovering, either that patient cannot be recovered, that is wrong. So this is a very important sign, which we will later on diagnose. And after that, when his wife come to us to the hospital, I just take the history. What happened? She says, he woke up with the pain in afternoon at 4 a.m. So confirm my diagnosis, and patient recover, and this was the bite site. Now this again, patient come with a pain in abdomen. Simple child was crying because of pain in abdomen. And we can, if you lift the shoulder, the neck falls suddenly. That's called broken neck sign. Confirm the patient has a crate bite. And this child has no history of bite at all. Again, this is a very important sign. This is again ptosis. Just like myasthenic face, that is no emotions at all. Patient gets saliva, is pulling up saliva, and this is a crate, and this is a bite here, and you have your tourniquet. Most important, never release this tourniquet unless you give a full dose of ASV. Full dose of ASV should be administered, never release the tourniquet, otherwise patient will suddenly die of respiratory arrest. Now, very important, how to diagnose respiratory failure. Single breath count is more than 30. Say, holding of breath for more than 45 minutes, if he complete one sentence, patient has a minimum respiratory failure. So you can have dyspnea, dysarthria, dyspnea, diplopia, and dysphagia, this sign of neurological manifestation, ptosis and paralysis. So again, patient can have chest pain because this patient has presynaptic block and release of postsynaptic cause adrenaline excess. And hypertension. Because of hypertension, patient gets a chest pain. Many times this patient admitted intensive care unit as a treatment for coronary heart disease. So this chest pain should be correlated. It's like a myasthenic-like face. No emotion at all. This is like internal, external ophthalmoplegia. Again, this patient has recovering from the crate bite, developed massive pulmonary edema because of BP raised, hypertension, needs sodium. So this is nitroglycerin and patient recover. So many times, the crate bite, many times doctor feels snake bite, BP ka kya len dena hai. You must take the BP of this. You must clinically examine each and every sign of patient. So ultimately, this patient was developed pulmonary edema and recover. Now again, many times patient come with this specimen of the crate on bite site, but there's no inflammation. Patient has no ptosis, no sign. So this is a dry bite. So you have to observe for 24 hours. So patient, because snake is very wise, professional or defense bite. Professional bite means he has to bite. He will get his prey. Defense bite means he's just threat to the victim. So this is a defense bite, which occurs called dry bite, doesn't need any treatment. So ultimately, this another snake look like a crate. Remember, this is very common in this university areas. This you must be different. Because this is a wall snake. Look at the tail. And look at the tail of a crate. Tail of the crate, wide band ends up to the end of the tail. The wide band stuff, one dot, two dots, and then continues. This is a venomous. While the tail is free from the wide band, is a non-venomous. So many times you miss, this is a crate. So they remember, wide band start from here, no wide band here. So this is the most important for this area. Next important, this child was taken as a crate bite, given 10 amperes, 60 amperes, 50 ASV, is a kill of ASV, unnecessary. A child may die by anaphylactic reaction. So you must be aware what is wall snake. Next, in terms of various clinical measures of crate bite, Yeah, midnight is the commonest bite manifestation. Now the patient generally sleep on the floor bed, which very is important. All where the bites can occur, not in the extremities, but backache. Even the scrotum, we have seen the snake great bite to the scrotum. Now, what are the clinical manifestations? We get a neuroparalysis. Now, many patients need a reference because of lack of ventilators. Local tissue damage is not at all there. No gangrene. Hypertension I have seen. Pulmonary edema we have seen. Reaction which can occur and kills patient about 53% during the craze and fatality was 11%. So now, cobra bite. So we have seen the crate. Crate is very important, mischievous. Many times crate bite cannot be diagnosed. That's how given important the crate in my lectures. Now the cobra, everybody know about the cobra. Everybody see the cobra. But what happened because of hyperventilation feeling and threat of life? Patient will, I will go to die. So this idea, patient gets surge of acetylcholine and dies of ventricular arrhythmias, cardiac arrest. So this is the most important experience. Patient may not be beaten by cobra at all. So patient get a threat. That's why in the child play with the cobra, get bite, but he never dies suddenly because he has no idea of death. Next important, rapid swelling which occur at the bite side. We have seen there is no swelling. Here is rapid swelling, ecchyma, local ecchymosis. Fangs mark with the blood clot. Blips, necrosis, ulceration is very common. Now this patient, no sin, see the cobra, he has marked ventricular arrhythmias, ventricular ectopics, and he is still just like I put in myocardial infarction. No sin, he see a doctor, it reverse the normal changes. So this is very important threat. Now the very important snake bite, we get common is a respiratory failure. Neuroparalysis is very common. Fatality is very less. Now tissue damage is very common in the cobra bite. We get more tissue damage. Gangrene, hypotension, shock and heavy reaction, very common. So the tissue local damage is a very common thing in cobra bite. Now this is cobra bite. See, within 90 minutes, we get a ptosis. And if a cobra bite is treated, you see, cobra bite failure occur of postsynaptic neuromuscular paralysis. Now the common is death because of paralysis conduction in neuromuscular junction. So you give neostigmine atropine first, then the ESV. Because by giving neurostim atropine, you are recovering neuroparalysis. Patient may, which had likely die within few minutes, respirator will recover, and that got a chance to get the ASV. So this is a very important. You must now patient was recovered. See, neurostigmine within 1-2 hours, patient recovered completely by the cobra bite. But neurology, this local damage persists for years together unless you may need a plastic surgery. So this is if any get one to in presence doctor all phase level, I would like to get cobra bite rather than the crate. Now this is very important. Now the neuropar, whether neostigmine to be given or not. You see, many times we got a short acting neostigmine given, they have a test dose, but this was not available. So just keep a high spec over the ptosis eye. This is ptosis, keep it high spec if it improves, because hypothermia sensitize the acetylcholine to the acetylcholine receptors. So if there is improvement with the cold hypothermia, patient is likely to respond to neostigmine. So you can give a neostigmine. This is a simple bedside test. Now this is very important. Again, unsung heroes like the Rao, that is Kumar from Goa. As first anesthetic, we reported use of neostigmine in neuroparalysis. He remains unsung for long, long days, but nobody knows our Indian heroes. This is who has first used neostigmine treatment of cobra bite. Now neostigmine, which is important, acetylcholinesterase inhibitor. Now you know neostigmine you can use in a dementia similar type neostigmine. This inhibits the acetylcholine, increase acetylcholine level, and we can get 2.5 milligram, means 5 cc of neostigmine preceded by atropine, repeated every half hourly till the patient improves. You can give calcium glucagon to improve neuromuscular circulation. So neostigmine is the initial drug for cobra bite followed by ESV and calcium gluconate. Now this is again, now this madam was talking, his son was going to become next rescuer. Now this is, you see, what if next rescuer feel, when he rescues the cobra, he feel he has won the Pakistan war. He bring everybody to us, this reporter and everybody give the interview. While during interview, he was beaten by the cobra and become unconscious, took 3 days to recover. And unnecessarily kill the medical energies. Unwanted medical energy is killed by this fellow. Next important, this young chap was to kiss the cobra, beaten to the cobra and died. Next is now the cobra, you see, there is post-synaptic receptor block, crate is pre and post, both receptor blocks. So, neostigmine, ESV work on both structures. Now, this is our publication. Now, this is various detail is given in various publications, pre-synaptic receptor and post-synaptic membrane. Now, the pre-synaptic receptor with the voltage gated calcium channel, acetylcholine vesicle liberation, and post-synaptic, this is action of post-synaptic membrane. Various channels are responsible to transmit and block by the venoms. Now, this coming to Russell viper. Now, Russell viper is most aggressive big snake, very big snake. Now, his fangs are very big size. And this is mobile by 180 degrees. The it can open by 180 degrees. And it bites to the deep to the muscle. Patient get a severe pain while bite. Patient get hypotension, giddiness, because venom is rich in bradykinin. And bradykinin cause hypotension sudden, and patient get hypotension and giddiness. Next important, because of bradykinin, bradykinase enzyme was in synthesized. And bradykinase inhibition give the birth to ACE inhibitor. We see an inhibitor is a boon to the hypertension and congestive cardiac failure. So, Lipril, Isonefil, that is Losartan, all drugs are better for this venom. Next important thing is now, this venom is most anticoagulant, this anticoagulant because it's the prothrombin to thrombin is rapidly converted and thrombin is metabolized by the fibrinogens and patient blood become incoagulable. And within no time, patient become incoagulable. Now, McFerney was a British hematologist who added the viper venom to the hemophilic blood. And hemophilic blood clotted. And he elucidated the coagulation cascade, for which he was awarded a Nobel Award. Russell viper is more in India. Nobel Award more in USA. Now, most important thing is, what is lacking, I don't know now in here. Next important thing is now, no soon, when you inject Russell venom in the rat, before removing the syringe needle, the rat become incoagulable, dead. So you must remain, whether he's correct or wrong. So this is so rapid decoagulation and coagulation defect developed by the Russell venom. That's why patient become decoagulated within no time. So no sin, the bite occurs. So now remember, even the snake, the fangs are so sharp and big, it can bite through the gum, this boot also, plastic boot. While patient is mowing in the soybean plantation, may get a snake bite. He may forget it may not be snake bite. So this is very important to know that the patient can get a bite like this. Now very safe. No soon bite occur. Bleeding start from bite site. Local DIC develops. So this is, they will bleeding never stop. So that is one of the diagnostic sign of Russell viper bite. Swelling occur, giddiness occur, blebs occur. This gangrene can occur. Extensive edema can occur. So this is bleeding, no sign, bites occur. So it is like a mathematics. Crate bite, no sign. Cobra bite, local edema. Russell viper, bleeding at the site. Now this extensive bite, bleeding from extensive site. This is mucous bloody. Where you will get an injury, you will get a bleeding. Now extensive edema, compartment syndrome. Now the renal failure, why is common in renal failure? Let us discuss of the renal failure. Because of fluid is accumulating in this swelling limbs, so we get hypotension. Next important, because of hypotension, we get pre-renal failure. We get hemolysis, the hemoglobin is accumulated in kidney tissue, we get kidney failure. Next important, interstitial nephritis, which can occur because of antigen-antibody reaction. So ultimately, this patient generally die of renal failure. So very important to diagnose compartment syndrome. Once you diagnose compartment syndrome, if the patient has to go to the surgeon, but provided the coagulation factor is recovered. Most important thing is, in this victim, the presence of pulsation doesn't exclude the compartment syndrome. Patient might get a severe pain while doing a passive movement. You must demonstrate hypostasia under which the nerve is passing. So this is an important diagnosis to diagnose compartment syndrome Russell viper. Okay, now again a child even get a crate, this is a compartment syndrome, huge swelling and blebs. This is a Russell viper. Next, please. Now edema, scrotal edema, severe scrotal edema. Next. Now many times patient, if you hand over this patient to surgeon, they will just do the split and more surgical traumas. Patient many times this patient died for renal failure. So minimal surgical invasion should be done in snake bite. Next, please. Now, edema, this is very important. Early stage, where antivenom to be given? You see, when injury occurs, edema never develops rapidly. Inflammation take more than few hours to 24 to develop edema. Only in snake bite, because of toxin, we charge the leukotriene and cytokine liberation locally. We get accumulation, rapid inflammation, rapid edema. So development of rapid edema indication, the victim is in venom, need antivenom. Next, please. Now, very important is inguinal adenitis, lymphadenitis. No sooner you get a bite, within 1 hour, patient gets severe pain in the regional adenitis, which is again diagnosis of envenomation. Next, please. Now, very important reaction which can occur. Platelet count is low. Many times anaphylactic reaction, urticaria, which can occur like this. Next, please. Now, cerebral infarct, because of early thrombosis, patient can gain hemiplegia and cerebral thrombosis. Next, please. Now, even patient died of hemorrhage because of not treated in time. Next, please. Now, this is very important. This is a rare syndrome, which is called capillary leak syndrome, which common in Russell vapor. We don't have treatment of capillary leak syndrome. If the victim gets conjunctival congestion or conjunctival edema, just like a puffy space, yeah, this lung show the bleeding in the capillaries. Most probably hematocrit values increase, creatinine is raised, and patient gets hypotension. This is called capillary leak syndrome. Etiology is not known. But still they believe, because of increased level of vascular toxin, which is apoptotic nitrotoxin, which is leaded by this venom. Next, now the nature of paper says antigen-antibody reaction locally release the liquid which causes vasodilatation. So antibody means ASV plus venom action itself release this phenomena is yet to be elucidated. Next, please. Now we get here, parotid swelling. Like say, parotid swelling. This parotid swelling, which is a diagnosis of capillary leak syndrome, very important in this victim. Next, please. Now we get various vasoactive protein enzymes which is liberated responsive for the capillary leak syndrome. Next. Now very important, this is a misery of my nation. This is a labor of sugarcane laborers. Now she was carrying the bundles of the sugarcane over the head. In that bundles there was a Russell viper bitten to the forehead and swelled hematas. So this is really misery of my nation. Still we have to go too long to get a Nobel Award. We have to treat the patient like this first. Next, please. Now this again we get in Russell viper, we can get in neuroparalysis, which is common in Kerala and Sri Lanka. But patient recover very fast. In additional to bleeding, we can get a neuroparalysis. Next, please. Now blips, local blips which can occur. See, this is a very important local blips, which blips in rich in antigen and toxins. You can aspirate this local blip, so recovery will be fast. Next, please. Now this is hematuria. RBC is excreted in the urine. This is hemoglobinuria. This is because of hemolysis which occur in the blood. This is a kidney tissue which are releasing RBC. So this is what's different between two. Next, please. Now this severe edema which occur with hematuria. Next, please. Now if you follow up the urine for every day, patient urine collect. So this is very important to observe the renal failure. If you see the urine collection every day and clear up the urine with the treatment, improves the patient. Next, please. Now, various renal failure can occur from 3 days to 8 days. So, this is very important to follow up this patient. Next. Now, this is Russell viper. We say this is very important. Two types of Russell viper, round, and this is the connection between two rounds are connected. Yes, there is no connection. This causes more renal failure than this is neck. Next, please. Now, we get a respiratory distress syndrome, bleeding in the lungs. Next, please. Now, many times, patient with Russell viper, because of tumor necrosis factor and myocardial depression factor, patient came in the shock with ventricular tachycardia. And ventricular arrhythmia needs a DC shock and ESV. You must be aware of this phenomena. Otherwise, many doctors are aware this patient develop myocardial infarction arrhythmia. So, venom itself can cause arrhythmia. Next, please. Now, this is a very common Russell viper, very common in young people. Next, please. Now, Russell viper, local tissue damage is 97%. Gangrene can occur. Bleeding is 98%. Renal failure is very common. Next, please. Now, this is, you know, preface of this Amte, Prakash Amte is working on the very remote area. He had demonstrated a snake to the school children, developed Russell viper. He was hypertensive, developed renal failure and recover. Next, please. So now, number type in this happen in this university also, environment also. This is python and this is Russell viper. Python look like a Russell viper, remember. So may not be, you should not kill a python which is non-venomous. Next, please. Now the Subba viper. This snake is most aggressive, very rapid moving snake. When the farmer moving in the grass, the snake bites and run away rapidly. The farmer sees a thorn prick. He is bringing to the patient to the doctor with a thorn prick. Diagnosed thorn prick, treated with thorn prick, cellulitis, patient will die of renal failure. Remember, any thorn prick, rapid edema is a snake bite unless until pruritus. Next please. Now this is bleeding, showers of the bleeding occur because of a kiss bite. Next please. Now epistaxis can occur in the patient, posterior pharyngeal bleeding. Next please. Now very important, many times patient forget snake bite and come with a weakness. But you dig out the history that he says, yes, I got a snake bite 15 days before and no, there is no bleeding now. But you make him cough. When you cough purposefully, he may bleed out sputum. So this indicates patient need antivenom. Next please. Now many times you get a deep fossa bleeding, which is rarely seen by the busy doctor. Next please. Now pallor, severe pallor is neglected as a snake bite. Next please. Now very common acute bleeding, bleeding is less in a kiss bite. Next please. Now this is very, this is rare found in hilly areas, particularly in Mahabaleshwar. We get this is a malar pit viper, we don't have antivenom. Next please. Now sea snake. Sea snake is very important. Tail is like this accelerator pedal of the car. And patient get a severe pain, neurogenic edema. Patient get myositis, rubbed myelitis and renal failure and hyperkalemia. A treatment of hyperkalemia is calcium gluconate, LASIK, dialysis and budoncin. Next please. Now this is a hum-nose viper which have found the Kerala and Cochin here. We don't have antivenom. Next. Now this is a pit viper. We don't have antivenom. This pair we get a severe edema. Next please. Now this look like a pit viper, but this is grip. This is a Russell viper. Look, this is a Russell viper, and this is a pit viper. Next please. Now this child was just crawling in the front of the house, get a pit viper bite, and severe edema. 6-month-old child, and the woman was very wise. She bring the pit viper. We treated with antivenom. Patient recover. Next please. So this pit viper has no mortality. Next. Now never give intramuscular injection. When snake bite come, never give intramuscular injection because of bleeding patient get big, huge hematoma. So never give TT to this patient immediately unless coagulation factor is corrected. Next please. Same is the edema, big edema. Next please. Now paraspecificity, because we don't have antivenom for the creatine, this pit viper and this Kerala viper venom. So we can use paraspecificity, antipolyvalent can be used because mother milk and cow milk doesn't differ. Next please. Now, telemedicine. I receive many phone calls all over the India. So I advise on the phone that this is treatment, provided doctor should call me, not the patient at all. Next, please. So now the antidote, what is the specific antivenom? Test dose should not be done. Total. Next, please. Now, this is our herpetologist. We did study in the Hopkins Institute that one bite, how much venom is injected. Cobra injects 60 milligram. So how much antivenom required is 100 ml. Crate require venom is 100 ml. Russell viper require more than 105 ml. So this is the first dose to be given to this victim. 100 ml of the antivenom, that is 10 ampoules of antivenom dissolved in 5% dextrose or normal saline given within half to 1 hour. This is a very important, you already should know. Next please. Now turbid. If you made IBK, turbid solution should be thrown away. Otherwise the patient get a severe reaction. It should be crystal clear. Next please. Next important, 20-minute simple test you can do in laboratory or even a ward boy, even a servant can do. Just take a blood of 2 to 3 cc, make it a new glass dry test to stand it like this for 20 minutes, tilt it. If the bleeding persists, patient needs invenom, need antivenom. And this test should not be done within 6 hours after giving antivenom, because 6 hours are required to prepare to release the coagulation factor from the liver. So this is very important test to diagnose and to readministrate the antivenom. Next please. Now this is here. This antivenom is prepared from the horse. Near about, he say how much? 3,500 lives are saved by this animal. And still we are not treating the patients. Next please. Now this is very important, giving antivenom. Give antivenom earlier so the venom will be reduced. Again venom will raise, the antivenom will neutralize. So we have to use 6-hourly dose of antivenom. Next please. Now microscope, you must have magnification lens because adrenaline, atropine and neostigmine is so small letters we cannot recognize, even the crate bite. And this is, next please. Now the antivenom, you know everybody, scorpion antivenom, snake antivenom is available. Next. Now this is test dose. Test dose of antivenom should not be done. Not at all. Don't kill the time for test dose. Next please. Test dose should, if the patient is tossing, you are doing test dose, you are killing half an hour, patient may die per espresso. Test dose is not indicated because test dose gives important by IG type, not C peptide, C complement type reaction. Next, please. Now, this doctor says, every important thing is given and ESV is not tested. What is important to the snake bite? ESV, not the other drugs. Next, please. Now, very important, see, pseudo excuses. Doctor gives pseudo excuses. Patient is sensitive to the test. That is pseudo excuse because you don't want to face the anaphylaxis. Next, please. Now, this WHO has said, no test dose should be done. Now, but what you should have adrenaline prepared, antihistaminic, steroid, IV fluid, amantadine. Doctor should sit by the side of patient till full dose of antivenom is given. That's why doctors avoid to give antivenom. Next important, if the patient goes in ambulance, should not be goes with drip of antivenom. Antivenom dose should be completed under that of the doctor, then he should go to the ambulance. Otherwise, doing ambulance, if he develop antivenom, he will die. Next, please. No, there's a no option. Antivenom has no contraindication unless patient is a dry bite, a non-venomous bite. Now, patient must give a full dose admission should be done. No test dose. A pride of snake bites to deserve the class A. This is very important. Rapid development of swelling is indication of antivenom. Next, please. Now, this everybody know intubations and this is a resuscitation. Next. How to do resuscitation is taught in a MBBS level. Next. Now, this is very important. Every primary health center, even university campus hospital must have in a PSV. Next, must have bamboo bag for maintenance respiration till you go to tertiary care hospital. Even from here to the tertiary class, you must put an bamboo bag. Next, you must have laryngoscope, a working battery. Battery should be working, otherwise well, it is lost dead batteries. Lao jaldi, chalta jaldi lao, by this time patient will be serious. So you must see, this is an bamboo bag. Next, please. Now you must have ventilator if available or laryngeal mask. Next, please. Now, next. Now this is where next. So this is simple for you. If the patient history of snake bite, local edema, absent, sleep on floor bed, abdomen pain, neuroparalysis, crate bite. If the local edema present, neuroparalysis, cobra bite. If bleeding, DIC, shock for a Russell wiper. Only acute bleeding, patient a Ickes bite. This is confirmed. This is just like mathematics. Next, please. So now dilatation, which I discussed in detail, is not indication of the brain dead. Next. Now, this is a dilemma. This child was brought almost dead. No sign of life at all. No heart rate, no respiration, but skin was worn, cobra bite. I resuscitated the child, and child recovered but brain dead, visited to life. So I would have restricted, not resuscitated, because this is a load to the family. But you think whether to be resuscitated or not, because what to say, patient is on now visual stage for lifelong. Next, please. Again, this is 10-month-old child which is resuscitated and the patient died on 5th day. So resuscitation should be avoided in brain dead child. Next. Now, duty, when a doctor treat the patient, what will save the earning member of family, save the farmer, son of the soil, father or mother, he may husband or wife, social worker, he may be scientist. Esteem, satisfaction, doctor, and experience to compete for next patient. That's very important. Next, please. Now, snake bite preventable. Yes, next. It is a preventable. Next, please. Now, what if prevention is a mother of cure? This is very important. What Bernard Shaw says, he has transferred 150 patients. But you have studied prevention, he would have preserved 150 millions. So, prevention is mother of cure. Next, please. Now, this is open toilet. One of the risk factor of snake bite, which are published in Lancet, many women dies of snake bite early darkness. Next important, even Chhatrapati, previous. Now, even in the Raigad Fort, you know Chhatrapati Raigad Fort, there in 300 before there is toilet in Queen Mahal. Next, please. In the government, they are preparing a toilet they are using for bathroom. They are going to store the grains. So this is the condition. Why this happening? We are not hitting the target. What is hitting a target? Give them education. Rather the providing facility, basic education needed. Education will solve all the problem of medical, increasing malnutrition, not providing them nutrition. Next, please. Now this is prevention of measures. See, simple mosquito net. See how I search out? 3 years, even all Hindus come to me with a crate bite, not a single Muslim. In one village, there are 50% Muslim, 50 Hindus. Where 5 Hindu patients come with a crate bite? I gone to the village. I found out how the sleep method. The poor Muslims sleep under mosquito net or bamboo cord. richest Hindu sleep on the floor bed without mosquito net. So I came to conclusion, mosquito net and safeguard prevent the great bite, snake bite, scorpion bite, and mosquito bite, malaria, filaria, dengue, encephalitis, chikungunya, Nipah virus. All this can be prevented by simple thing. So, and this is published in Lancet in local language. And they have sent me £300 price. Next, please. Now, again, simple mosquito net, my dear friend, prevent the great bite. Next. So, this is again, next, please. Now, go to snake bite, scorpion thing. Next, snake, continue. Crusade against us. Next. Next, last. This very important side. See, now important, now see the Abdul Kalam, we have served his life for life. When he talking lecture, he fall down because of cardiac arrest. And that the fellow which around him was not trained, he would have not lifted, he was asleep and given resuscitation, he would have survived. So topmost person of the India is not getting proper treatment. What of the labor and farmer? Next, please. This is very important for doctor or everybody. Everybody is student till death. Or shall I say, waste is just to be student, he dies. Don't change the class, repeated ornament, changing bungalow has no value. You change the books, please. Next, please. Next. And now this is the place where I work on scorpion bite. Okay, 15 minutes. Huh. Now this is a primary health center where I work for scorpion bite in 1976, where the mortality was 40%. It is my pilgrimage. I take primary health as a pilgrimage. Everybody think primary health, nothing can be done. Everything can be done in primary health because raw material comes there. Sophistical, well-trained material go to district place with minimum research. Is the maximum research we get at primary health center. So this is the place where I work on search of the problem where the mortality was 40%. Next, please. Now this, what were my laboratories? Blood pressure and stethoscope. This is age-old golden companion doctor. This is my laboratories, not the CT scan, whatever modern investigation we got. And this, because what? The scorpion stick patient, nobody took the blood pressure at all. They say it is a shock hypotension. I took the BP, vomiting, sweating, codex meeting, BP was more than 200. So hypertension because of catecholamine excess. Next, please. Now this, how I train a doctor, so? We train a doctor by going to cattle shed because it's a life-saving research. I don't mind to talk under the tree because I want to train a doctor to reduce the mortality in battle. Next, please. Next, please. Tell next. Next, kara, scorpion kara, pude. Next. Yes, next. Next. Now this, everybody should know how to collect the mental data to prepare the publication. You see? How many patients you treated has no value. How many you publish very nicely, which enlighten the world, that is more value. Whatever may be hypothesis you got, you must come out some conclusion for publication, not to get the PhD. Next, important tackling of the rural problem is very important. Now the research journey, see, various paper I published, Lancet, NEGM, next please. Now again, next. Now this year is mushrooming of the hospital. If you go to Hyderabad, there is mushrooming of clinics in the highway. Many, many clinics with minimum research, no publication. Many patients, when discussed, I have seen such patients. Or whether it's published or not, you can say anything. There's no value. So this is very bad is happening in India. Nobody brings the Nobel Award to India. Everybody mushroom going to village, going to countries, moving the world. No contribution to my nations. Next, please. Now this, you see, this is a pilgrimage of my research. This is a makkah of my research. Next, please. Now the doctor, you see, I am still reading Lancet, BMJ, and NEGM regularly. Next, please. Now this is again same side. Next. Now life's time research. I did a scorpion thing, mortality 40 years, next person, snake bite. We are just infarction. Needle to hospital time is 20 minutes in my hospital. Where it is in Hyderabad, more than 1 hour, 30 minutes. You have to prepare the paper, everything is easy. Acute now, fluorosis you have seen our area. Chronic renal failure in the farmers because of cadmium toxicity. Half life of cadmium is 24 years. Dementia, we have made our simple method of RBC cholinesterase to diagnose dementia rather than MRI and CT scan. RBC cholinesterase. Then homocysteine, one of the cause of hypertension. because of we are worried about the purity, sterilization of water, sterile water, bisleri water, B complex deficiency. C peptide, homocysteine, vitamin D, burkha and farmers, because of black skin, resistant to vitamin D synthesis. They are more common vitamin D deficiencies. Next important now, the ear crease, simple ear crease in the ear crease, impending sign of myocardial infarct or ischemic heart disease. You get a ear crease in the sign, is suggested your patient should be investigated. And thyroid now, I have searched, this yet to be published, that iodinated salt is responsible for hypothyroidism. Next, please. Now, this is my research translation in 1978. See, typewriter, then projectors and slide, 35 MSIL. This is that era we did a research. Now it is gone to the museum, but still remains gold standard. Next, please. Now this is again, next, please. Now this next scorpion sting news around 1978. Next, please. Now this how the patient come with a massive pulmonary edema. Patient brought to the massive pulmonary, dead, massive pulmonary edema. Nobody believes death can occur to scorpion sting. Though 1932, British physician reported pulmonary edema from Bellary. Nobody was aware, even WHO is not aware of this death. Next, please. Now, many times we get maxim, this is a snake responsible for pulmonary edema. See? Next, please. Now, ECG changes, much monophasic complex. Those were just like monophasic complex, almost dead complex and pulmonary edema. Next, please. Now, marked tentative TVS. Myocardial infarction-like pattern. Look at this ECG and this ECG. The cardiologists are afraid. They have never seen such ECGs in the record. Even myocardial, they have never seen such ECGs. Next, please. Now, marked heart rate, 300 per minute. Just like that. And patient is recovered with our treatment. Next, please. Even marked tentative TVS gradually improves. Next, please. Massive pulmonary edema in the Brazil. That time we don't have research, we don't have laboratory, we don't have university, we don't have teacher. Nobody taught to me. There is no reference in the textbook scorpion sting. So what I did, I compare with my clinical manifestation to Brazil. So Brazil has a similar clinical manifestation. So Brazil scorpion, they are research. Israel, similar. So Israel people are searching out. So we study this scorpion, then communicate with the Israel, and then we come to know this is severe phosphoconstriction pulmonary edema. Next, please. Now this. Same day we get a pulmonary edema recover, same day with patient from Crusade by it. So emergency life side. Next, please. This is again for next, please. Now PSC, scorpion fatality was 40%. Then again we are reducing, this is because of our pilgrim, we are publishing many articles. Next, please. Next. Now PSA, when I joined the primary health center, my compounder said his 6 years old boy died of pulmonary edema due to scorpion sting. So I searched with the oral autopsy. What is the clinical? He said, no, son, the bite occurred. Patient has a mild pain. Then pain disappear automatically. Patient has sweating, cold extremity, tachycardia, hypotension. 3 days patient was breathless, cold extremity, and patient died of sudden cardiac arrest. So ultimately, it is a pulmonary edema responsible, and the WHO was not aware. Next, please. So this is a scorpion. Look at, when you get a scorpion, look detail. Look at the pincer. They are narrow, slender, and tail is stout and healthy. This is a venomous. This is again, though it is a venomous. This is again a venomous. Look at the reverse, then none. These all are venomous. Look at the pincer and the tail. Pincer is small and slender as compared to tail. Next, please. Now, many times, this paddy has covered with October month, we get many cases of scorpion sting. Next, please. Now, many times, pulmonary edema. Mark when tachycardia, left anterior hemorrhage block, massive changes in the heart, confirmed is a cardiogenic pulmonary edema. It is due to heart defect, heart damage, and we get a massive bathyal pulmonary edema. And red color oxygen to blood because of rupture of pulmonary veins, which carrying the pure level because of increased left atrial pressure. And this is a scorpion responsible for pulmonary edema. Next, please. Now, we did a histopathology, which confirmed there is pulmonary edema in the lungs and myocardial damage. Next, please. Now, this again, we get a excessive sweating, dilated pupils, see, pupils are dilated, profuse sweating, oculoparotic crisis, so excessive sweating persists for 8 to 17 hours. Next, please. Dilatation pupils, when treated with patient, become recovered with the normal pupils. Next, please. Now, this we published in 1978, I published the mortality was near about 29%, while the Mudley has published the mortality of the same type of mortality. Same what I published in 29, Amundle is 1961. So from 1961 to 78, it was silence. Next, please. Now this is scorpion is non-venomous. Look at, this is the stout, big stout pincer, a slender. This is less venomous. Next, please. Now we get a severe pain because of non-venomous sting. Next, please. Now local xylocaine should not be used repeatedly because local repeated xylocaine will form more inflammation and inflamed tissue xylocaine won't act. Next, please. Now this is a very venomous, less venomous and less venomous. Next, please. Same in India. We get a venomous type and this is less venomous. Next, please. Now this again less venomous and they look, why I'm looking? So look at the scorpion when you feel aware of this size. Next. So this is again Kerala. We get neuroparalysis. Next, please. Now we get in another district and Maharashtra, we get 10 TV, same black scorpion, red scorpion, similar changes occur. Next, please. So pulmonary edema, massive pulmonary edema in other district with patient reported to me. Next. Now again, myocardial infarction pattern which occur. This is another district, this is my district. So number of district species differ, still the clinical manifestation are same. Next. Now this is a viviparous, give birth to the young ones. And the young ones nibble the mother till they die. As the corrupted people and politicians killing our India. Next, please. Now, scorpion is all over India. Next, please, all over the world. Now, very common scorpions in all over the India. Now, we are getting report from all over India. Next, please. Now, this both month, this is April to June and October. This is two seasons with very high mortality scorpions thing. Next, please. Now, aculogyric crisis we can get. This is like aculogyric crisis because of parasympathetic stimulation. And the doctor may feel is a ptosis. So it is not, but the sweating and vomiting confirmed again a priapism, which is diagnostic of scorpion sting. Next, please. Aculogyric crisis and sweating. Next. See, look at the sweating. So ropy salivation. He unable to spit out thick salivation, which is a diagnosis. Cold extremity. Eyes cold. Just like washerman sand like cold extremity. Patient will not go to the sleep. Patient occur not reduce till the patient get a cold extremities. Or patient may not pass urine any amount of diuretics. So cold extremity, but no pain at all, cold, because of the conducting fibers are anoxicated, no pain conduction at all. So scorpion sting, no pain at all. When we get vasodilatation improvement, patient get a severe local pain. So reappearance of pain, which absent, confirm the recovery of the patient. Next, please. Now this BP apparatus weighted with the sweating. Next, please. Now this vasoconstriction, after improvements, vasodilation, patient improves. Next, please. Now, severe priapism is a very diagnosing children because many times children have no pain at all, come with sweating and priapism, confirm my diagnosis, scorpion sting. Next, please. Now, so look at the sweating, see? Next. Now, many times we get a hemiplegia because of thrombosis, because of liberation of free radicals. Next, please. Now, what we get? Local pain, vomiting, salivation, priapism, then cold extremities, pulmonary edema, hypertension, tachycardia, bradycardia, murmur, gallophone, petal. So, the spectrum of 1%. Patient gets sweating, hypertension not treated. Patient gets pulmonary edema, tachycardia, hypotension, shock. Next, please. Now, very important, as time progresses, patient tachycardia will increase. Next, please. Now, atropine was routinely used in my area because to cause the sweating. Atropine has killed many patients because parasympathetic is protective phenomena. Next, please. Now, mild tachycardia, this child was died because of atropine. Next, please. Now, most clinical manifest which occur is vomiting, very common since sweating, cold extremities, priapism, hypertension, pulmonary edema, 41%. Next, please. Now, this typical pulmonary edema is in unilateral, bilateral pulmonary lungs. Next. Now, my heart was echocardia, so stunning up. Heart doesn't contract at all. It's stunned. Just like if you look at a lion, you get stunned. Stunning of the heart occurred because of excessive autonomic storm. Next, please. Now, scorpion venom delays the closing of sodium neuronal channel. It inhibits the potassium channel, resulting in sudden autoimmune endogenous catecholamine autonomic storm. It's a transient parasympathetic prolonged sympathetic stimulation. Transient means vomiting, sweating, salivation is transient. Prolonged means hypertension, tachycardia, and pulmonary edema. Transient indicates venom is circulating in the blood, and prolonged indicates adrenaline has action. Next minute. Now, this is various clinical manuals. Just as I talk in detail of the choline X-rays, vomiting, sweating, lacrimation, priapism. Hypotension shock and parasympathetic stimulation, sympathetic will tachycardia, hypertension, midriasis. This all the clinical manifest because of autonomic stimulation. Next, please. Now, this I published in the new similar manifestation in diagnostic present in NEGM. Next, please. Now, it is like autonomic storm. When there is bombardment, somebody run away, somebody cry, somebody laugh, there are irrational response. So, similarly, body response is random. Somebody will hypertension, somebody will bradycardia. So, it is a rapid, random body response. Next, please. So in one ECG, we get all signs of tachycardia, ventricular arrhythmia, block, and various atrial fibrillation. Single ECG of one patient, scorpion sting. Next, please. Now, many times patient get a marked tachycardia, which can needs a close observation. Next, please. Now, patient with a scorpion sting, with the sweating, because of acetylcholine excess, cause coronary vasodilation, atherosclerosis, patient getting infarction. This patient has scorpion sting with myocardial infarct, required thrombolysis and antivenom. Next, please. Again, next, please. Now, my patient had cardiac arrest. Patient died of cardiac arrest. Okay. Now, this I think the enough, now, enough slide. This we get a marked bradycardia and marked tachycardia and tentative. Next. Thank you. Okay. Yes.
Thank you, sir. That was a very interesting talk indeed. I mean, like, you didn't just cover the clinical and the research side, but you also covered the general knowledge every common man should know to help oneself and to help others as well. Thank you, sir. May I now request Professor Prakash Babu, Pro Vice Chancellor and Dean School of Medical Sciences, to present the speaker, Dr. H.S. Bawaskar, with a memento.
So we apologize for actually cutting it short. It was very interesting because even you have to catch the fly. It's amazing, sir. Your passion is really touching. Thank you very much. We're honored to have you here.
Such a nice talk and telling not only the faculty and the students that how much important it is to do reading. And the other thing is, for doing research, you don't need any big equipments, as sir has said, and he has got so many publications by having a very simple lab. So I will really thank him for coming here and giving a talk. I would like to thank the administration and the PRO office for all the support. I would like to thank Dean School of Medical Science, Professor Geeta, and all the faculty and all the students present here for making it a big success. Thank you, one and all.